Wild Strawberries is written and directed by Ingmar Bergman. That came out in 1957. That stars Victor Sjostrom. So Wild Strawberries is a patron poll winner that's a week overdue. I just got really busy with cramming in a lot of 2020 films and preparing for those two top 20 lists. One of them being the top 20 quarantine recommendations of 2020. And the other is just the top 20 best movies of 2020. So please feel free to check those lists out if you haven't already. And also please don't forget that if by the end of this video, if you really end up enjoying it, please give it that thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. So Wild Strawberries is one of the many Criterion films that I blind bought during the Barnes & Noble Criterion sale. So I decided to put it up on a poll. Obviously it won. And I have a gigantic confession to make that's pretty embarrassing. I have never seen an Ingmar Bergman film. That's one of my nice handful of just straight cinema blasphemy, straight cinema sins that I've committed. So needless to say, I went into this film with pretty high expectations because I just heard so much about Ingmar Bergman and how brilliant of a filmmaker he is. And now after having seen Wild Strawberries, I can easily say that I am extremely excited to check out what else Ingmar Bergman has done. Films like The Seventh Seal, films like Shame, films like Persona, which I'm dying to see. Because Wild Strawberries, I think, is going to serve as a great example of what Ingmar Bergman is capable of as a filmmaker. And it gave me a really excellent idea of his approach to filmmaking. I mean, I'm sure he decides to shake things up and has different approaches to certain films, depending on which one it is. But Wild Strawberries pretty much goes down these really philosophical and honest roads that I really appreciated, because it's a film that is completely unafraid to explore really important life themes like guilt and forgiveness, naivete versus wisdom, science and religion. And it explores all these things in a way that doesn't feel like it was telling me what to believe and telling me how to feel. And that's one of the things that I really appreciate out of this film. Is that, yeah, it's a pretty talky film. Like, I think it's a little bit more talky than I expected. I was expecting something that was a little bit more visual than what I got. But most of the conversations and most of the voiceover narration, well, it's not really narration, it's more of like inner thoughts. A lot of that was really thought-provoking and insightful writing. Because the film follows this old man, and he kind of goes on this little journey. And through this journey, he kind of confronts his demons, confronts a lot of his past regrets, and has a lot of time to reflect on everything that has happened in his life that is of significance. And he reflects on a lot of the choices that he's made that has cost him certain things in his life that he's not sure was really worth it. And I really enjoyed how the film decided to dive into these things. But I will say that my favorite aspect of the film were definitely the more visual aspects, because this film is compiled of a handful of either dream sequences or flashback sequences that seem dreamlike. And those are by far my favorite aspects of the film. Even though I enjoy the writing for what it is, and I think it's really well written, those visual sequences I found to be incredibly stunning, especially for a film that came out in 1957. And I think my favorite sequence is probably that beginning dream sequence that we get like in the first 5 minutes of the film. That seems like something that I would want to make as an aspiring filmmaker. And to see someone accomplish a dream sequence like that so early in cinema history is really inspiring. And I understand that it's not like an ancient film. It's not an incredibly old film that was like made in the 20s or anything like that. But it's still a fairly old film. And it's one of those films that do feel pretty timeless, and there's really nothing about this film that feels dated, which is really impressive. And as I said, I think the visual aesthetic sequences of this film were the strongest points of it. And I do kind of wish that we had more of that in the film, because there are only a handful of moments that actually have that. And again, the rest of it is a pretty verbal and talky type of film, which again works for the most part, but it just doesn't hit the same as those visual sequences, and I wish there was just a little bit more of it. And this is quite a symbolic film as well. I feel like there are a lot of things in this film that serve as metaphors, And I feel like this is definitely a film that is trying to demonstrate that famous theme of it being a lot more about the journey than it is about the destination. And again, that's like, to me, that seems like a really obvious metaphor for life and death. But this is a pretty mature film and relies on a lot of heavy philosophy. So I can see a handful of people watching this film and just finding it a little bit boring. And I obviously really didn't find it boring because this is a pretty short film as well. It's only an hour and a half. But I feel like this is a film that you kind of have to have a mature mindset in order to really appreciate on this level. And I'm not really saying that to be arrogant or to be on a pedestal. I'm just saying that this is definitely not a film that you can just watch with your average Joe and expect them to be really engaged by it. But either way, I really enjoyed how this film explored and demonstrated its philosophical themes through the reflections of this old man's life. And I just found it to be a really honest and mature exploration of these kinds of philosophical themes. And overall, I really enjoyed this film, even if I wish there was just a bit more of a visual aesthetic aspect to this film. Because when those aspects are actually in the film, I think that he just knocks it out of the park and really nails it. So I'm going to give Ingmar Bergman's Wild Strawberries a soft 8 out of 10. Yeah, I'm incredibly excited to explore more of Ingmar Bergman's filmography. I'm definitely going to be watching Persona next because that was honestly the first one that I wanted to watch. But there were a nice handful of people telling me that that's not where I should start. So I took their word for it. And I started with Wild Strawberries, and I bought that and put it on the poll specifically because one of my Patreon subscribers, Chris Gatan, so sorry if I mispronounced that, I probably did. He's the one that really loves this film a lot and has been really encouraging me and pushing me to watch this film. And luckily, it won the poll, so here's a review for it. But yeah, needless to say, just from this film alone, I am ecstatic to finally dive more into his filmography. But that's all I got to say about Wild Strawberries. If you really enjoyed what I had to say about this film, please give it a thumbs up and share it amongst your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel to be updated on more film-related content.